हॅलो डिअर ऑल, हिअर इज वसंती रेवतकर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, श्री ज्ञानेश महाविद्यालय, नवरगाव, डिस्ट्रिक्ट चंद्रपूर. हिअर इन दिस व्हिडिओ आय एम गोईंग टू एक्सप्लेन फॅमिली मायमोसेसी, विच इज इन्क्लुडेड इन द सिलेबस ऑफ सेमेस्टर टू इन द गोंडवाना युनिव्हर्सिटी, गडचिरोली. सो इन दिस लेक्चर we are going to explain the content of the family mimosaceae. About this family, the systematic position of this family, that is, what is the position of this family in the any classical system of classification, then diagnostic feature of this family, important genera which are included in this family, distribution of plants, where these plants are mostly distributed, then habitat and habit, that is of these plants included in the family mimosaceae, vegetative characters shown by the plants, then reproductive characters of the plant, and lastly economic importance of this family. Now we are studying one by one. Systematic position, this family mimosaceae is included in the division Phandrogam, subdivision Angiospermae, class Dicotyledons, then subclass Polypetali, series Calyciflora, order Rosalis, family Leguminosae, and subfamily Mimosaceae. Previously, system of classification proposed by Bentham and Hooker, this Mimosaceae was included in the family Leguminosae, and that's why this systematic position tells about the family and given the rank of subfamily, as this is given by Bentham and Hooker system of classification. But nowadays this is the separate family. Previously it was included in family Leguminosae, and the name of the family Leguminosae was not ending in a CEE. And according to that International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, the name of the family must be ended in CEAE, and according to that rule, now the family Mimosaceae has given the rank of family Mimosaceae. Then distinguishing characters, the plants of this family are usually tree or shrubs with leaves stipulate, compound and bipinnate. Inflorescence is generally racemose and globose, and globose head. Flowers are actinomorphic. Generally the flowers are actinomorphic. Then stamens many. This is the very important characteristic feature of this family Mimosaceae. Gynoecium monocarpellary and fruit lomentum. And lomentum is nothing but the somewhat legume, and that's why the plants which are having the fruits like legume, all these plants were included in the family Leguminosae. Important genera, there are about 40 genera in this family. Some of them are Acacia arabica, Acacia catechu, then Albizia, then Calliandra, then Enterolobium, and then Lucina, then Mimosa pudica, then Neptunia oleracea, then Pithocolybium dulce, then Prosopis, and last one is the Xylia. These are some of the plants included in the family Mimosaceae. Then distribution, the plants are exclusively tropical or subtropical. In our country, this family is represented by Acacia, that is Babul, then Mimosa, then Neptunia, Prosopis, then Senegal, and Albizia. These are very common plants which are found in our country. And habitat and habit, the members show great variation in habitat. Some are mesophytes and some are xerophytes. Then Neptunia oleracea is free floating hydrophytes, means all types of habitat are found here. Some are mesophytes, some are xerophytes, and some are floating hydrophytes also. then vegetative characters, which includes roots, taproot and branched, deep rooted in the soil. Then stem is erect, branched, woody and solid. The stem tissue is often rich in tannin sacs and gum passage. Therefore, almost all plants which are found in this family, Mimosaceae, they possess gum passages and they exclude the gum. Then leaves. The leaves are alternate, then petiolate, then leaf base is pulvinous. Stipules are modified into thorns. Compound leaf is present. Bipinnate. Leaf movements are common. Common, that is gnostic movement shown by family genus Mimosa pudica. It is also called as touch me not. When we touch the leaf, it shrinks down. Then in Acacia, petioles are being flattened and developed into phyllodes. Then reproductive characters. In flowers is racemose or globose or head or spike. These are the inflorescences. Some inflorescences we have shown here. We can see here. These are the inflorescences. These are the globose. Then flowers. Usually flowers are sessile, actinomorphic. Actinomorphic means when we cut the flower in the center of the, when we cut the flower from the center, we will get two equal halves. Then regular. Regular means complete, all the four whorls are there. And then hermaphrodite, bisexual flower. Then then hypogynous flower, complete and small. Then flowers in Mimosa are tetramerous. Flowers, they are consist of four different whorls: calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Calyx consist of 4 to 5 sepals. They are gamosepalous, more or less conate, green and small. Activation, estivation is valvate type. Then corolla, petals are 4 or 5, polypetalous, slightly united towards the base, and estivation is valvate here also. Then androecium, stamens infinite. There are number of stamens, they are infinite, and sometimes they are 4 in Mimosa. Conspicuous and brightly colored. This is the very important characteristic feature. The stamens are conspicuous and brightly colored. Then they are attractive also and somewhat scented. And anthers bisel, dehiscence by longitudinal slit, filaments long and slender. Gynoecium. The fourth and very important whorl is gynoecium. That is, carpel is one, monocarpellary, ovary superior, unilocular and marginal placentation, style long and filiform, then stigma, terminal and simple. Then fruit is lomentum. This fruit, they are legume like, but there are the constrictions as like this one. And this fruit is called as the lomentum or the legume. This is about the floral formula and floral diagram. Floral formula, flowers are actinomorphic, then bisexual, then calyx 5 united, corolla 5 united or free, then androecium infinite, gynoecium single, one carpel and having superior ovary. Economic importance of the family. The plants present in the family Mimosaceae are very economically important. Some plants yield timber, some plants are medicinally important, some plants yield dye and some plants are ornamental. Means all types of economic importance are there. Means they are timber yielding plants, medicinally important plants, then dyes yielding plants and ornamental plants are also included, and that's why the family is of great economic importance. Then first one is Acacia arabica, or it is called as bubble or kicker, and Indian gum or Arabic tree. This is the lomentum and this is the flower of this plant. This is the inflorescence, head or globose inflorescence, and this is the twig of this plant. It is distributed throughout arid and semi-arid zones of the world. Then next one is Acacia catechu or Mimosa catechu. It is commonly called as khair, from which we can exude the katha, or we get the katha which we use in the pan. When we chew the pan, then or it is dye. Katha is used as a dye, and that's why it is dye yielding plant. It is commonly known as Mimosa catechu or commonly called as Acacia catechu. Very useful in the treatment of asthma. And katha tree also, it is called as the khair or katha tree, and it also serves as a lac insect host. The katha is obtained from heartwood and used as dyeing and preservating agent. Then next one is the Acacia arabica. It is also called as subabur, and then it is also the inflorescence, globose inflorescence. It grows throughout the drier part of the country. It is a moderate sized, almost evergreen tree with short trunk and slender crown of the branches. The bark is dark brown and almost black, then longitudinally are fissured or deeply cracked. The leaves are two-pinnate and the main rachis has glands. Stipular spines are variable. Leaflets are subsessile and glabrous. Flowers pink, fragrant, crowned in the long stalked globose head. Then Albizia lebac. This is the plant, Albizia lebac. This is the green colored inflorescence, and another way also the red color and pink colored also there is. This is the ornamental plants grown in the garden for its beautiful inflorescence. This is Albizia saman, and it has pink colored inflorescence, and it is also bipinnate and distributed in all over our country. The plant is grown as an ornamental plant. Then this is Calliandra. It is large genus of the tropical plant that consists of about 200 species of small tree and evergreen flowering shrub. That is Calliandra hematocephala, means hematocephala means there are red, very bright red colored inflorescences there. Inflorescence and the flower is having long stamens which are colored red colored, and for that one it is a red color, red flower like structure, but it is inflorescence. Commonly known as powder puff tree. It is native of South America. Then Mimosa pudica, commonly it is called as Tasminot lazaru, or it is a creeping annual perennial flowering plants which is of the family Mimosaceae, and it is cultivated in the garden for its beautiful inflorescence. But many of them, it looks like a flower, but it is globose inflorescence. When we touch the leaflets, it shut down and reopened after few minutes later. Then Neptunia oleracea, commonly known as known in English as water mimosa or sensitive Neptunia, is a pantropical nitrogen fixing perennial legume. Genus and common name come from the Neptune, a god of the sea. Then this is Prosopis cineraria. It is also known as gaff. Is a species of flowering plant of the family. It is native to arid portion of Western Asia and Indian subcontinents. It is also called commonly grown in the garden for its inflorescence. Then next one is Xylia xylocarpa. It is deciduous tree with a dense crown, usually growing 20 to 40 meters tall, though on dry and poor site of the tree may be smaller and crooked. The bole is usually straight and cylindrical, sometimes with small buttresses. it can be unbranched for 12 meters or more and around 40 to 60 centimeter in diameter. The plant is mainly harvested from the wild. It is cultivated as shade tree in the South India and for fodder of the fodder plant, fodder for the cattle. Then it is Pithocephalus dulse. It is called as a jungle ki jalebi or called as English chinzo. It is commonly known as Manila tamarind or Madras thorn. It is also called as it is commonly called as in Hindi it is jungle ki jalebi, and it is found in the Central America and North South America also. Then thank you very much.